Hi, I'm Stephen Jiang, CNN's Beijing producer. I was born and raised here in China and have been covering this country for CNN since 1999. A lot has changed during my time here, but even in today's ultra-modern Beijing, there's still plenty of quaint charm to be found if you know where to look. If you have a couple of hours to kill between meetings during the day, come here to the Hohai Lake. This was once the Empress's backyard, but now it's a great place to take a leisurely stroll. You can take a glimpse of traditional Beijing life in one of the many colorful back alleys, or just sit down at a cafe or tea house around the water to enjoy the view or to people watch before your next meeting. When it comes to doing business here, a lot of deals are still being discussed or sealed at banquet tables. One thing that's inevitable at these settings is Baijiu, a very strong Chinese rice liquor and definitely an acquired taste. So if you don't want to get wasted or wake up with a terrible hangover, stand your ground politely but firmly. Because if you cave in and start downing that first cup of Baijiu, there's no turning back. Flying to Beijing has become much easier for Americans these days. All three major US airlines, United, Delta, and American, offer multiple non-stop flights into Beijing from their hubs across the US every day. Personally, I like to take a flight that arrives either in late afternoon or early evening, because that means you only have to try to stay up for a few hours before getting a whole night of sleep. That's usually the best way to get rid of jet lag. When you arrive at the massive Beijing airport, the best way to get into town may be a little counterintuitive. There is an airport express train, but its two stations in the city are not the most convenient locations. It's often difficult to get a cab from the stations to get to your hotel. So despite the notorious traffic here, it may still be easier to just book a hotel car to pick you up. Sure, it's a little pricier than the usual $25 to $30 cab fare, but it gives you peace of mind after a long-haul flight. If you take a taxi or grab a street snack, remember, cash is still king on the streets here, so do change some money upon arrival or at your hotel. But the good news is, more and more shops and restaurants now take credit cards, including foreign-issued ones. And the better news? Apple Pay is now available across China. So get ready to use your iPhone to pay for that delicious meal of Peking duck.